Welcome to TipUp, quick tech tips so you can work smarter. You've just finished creating a survey for a research project in Qualtrics and are just about to send it off. While it's always a good idea to have someone you trust test your survey, sometimes you want to see what your dataset or reports will look like without taking the survey over and over again. If you want to create dummy data in a hurry, you can easily generate test responses in Qualtrics. When you're done creating your survey, click the Tools button to open a drop-down menu and select Generate Test Responses. A new pop-up window will appear asking you to input the number of test responses you'd like Qualtrics to create. These responses will be generated using the draft version of your survey. When deciding on a number, it's important to note that if your survey is long, your request may time out if you try to generate too many responses at once. If this happens, try generating test responses in multiple smaller batches. You can also click on additional options to play with other parameters for your test responses, like allowing unanswered questions and showing verbose output for text-related questions. For more advanced options, you can even add query strings under additional URL parameters to capture embedded data fields. Once you set up your parameters, click Generate. Qualtrics will start going through test iterations for each response you requested. To see the test responses, go to the Data and Analysis tab. Each row represents a generated response. If you export the raw data into a format like Excel, you'll be able to see under the status column that the answers are survey tests and not real data collected in your study. Note that there are some cases where you may not be able to generate test data, or the responses may give unexpected results. This includes surveys with an authenticator element in your survey flow, a table of contents, or a loop and merge block. There are also certain question types that are incompatible with test data, and if your survey has custom validation, it won't be applied to test responses. If you're not satisfied with how the data is being collected, you can go back into your survey and change it. However, if you like how the data appears, it's a good idea to delete the test responses when you're finished working on your survey. In your Data and Analysis tab, you can select all of your test responses and hit the trash can icon to delete. Visit qualtrics.com/support for more information on generating test responses. Want more TipUp? Watch our videos and submit your ideas at its.weill.cornell.edu/tipup.